The Smart School Class 3 Science Video Lesson 2. We shall continue to study chapter number 1, that is Earth as a Living Planet. Today, our topic of study is habitat and its different types. We shall study from pages 2 and 3. Before the start of the lesson, you will need Smart Science 3, your notebook and your pencils in order to carry on with the lesson. Are you ready? By the end of this lesson, you should be able to define habitat. Name some plants and animals living in your surroundings. Identify 5 different types of habitat. Describe the features of organisms living in polar regions. So, we shall start with a bit of a recap of the previous lesson. Do you remember what are the factors that sustain life on Earth? These factors are: number 1, temperature; number 2, light; number 3, water; number 4, air; and number 5, soil. These are the basic needs of a living organism. So the living organisms need to live at a place where they find all of these things suitable to their bodies. All living things need a home. What is being shown in this picture? You can see a polar bear in a desert. What is wrong with this picture? A polar bear cannot live in a desert. A polar bear lives in cold places and it is their habitat. Can you guess the meaning of the word habitat? The word habitat means the environment in which plants and animals live. Just as we saw in the case of a polar bear, its habitat are extremely cold places. These are 4 different types of habitats. This is the one that we have just seen. For the polar bear, this is the main grasslands, this is a mountainous area, and this is a desert. All these different types of habitats have different types of living organisms. Can you name some plants and animals that share your habitat? Think of some plants and animals that live in the area around you. Are these some of those animals? Goat, cow, wheat crop, grapes, dog, and tomatoes. How many of these living organisms, plants and animals, live in the area nearby you? So these are the different types of habitat. First is polar region that we have gone through a bit. The second one is forests. The third one is deserts. Number 4 is mountains. And number 5 is rivers and seas. All these different places have different types of living things in them. These living things cannot survive if you take them to other places. For example, camels will not survive in mountains, and fish will not survive in deserts. So, polar region is the habitat that we are going to study in detail. Can you name some animals living in the polar region? One of them is of course the polar bear that we have just seen. These are some other animals that live in the polar region. One of them is leopard seal. The other one is penguin. You may have seen penguin in different cartoons. Arctic wolf and polar bear, Arctic fox and walrus. Do you know how does the land look like in the polar regions? The land in the polar regions is always covered in snow. It doesn't matter what time of the year it is, either it is January or it is June or it is December, these areas are always covered in snow, just as you can see in this picture. So you can see a polar bear sleeping peacefully in such cold climate. You can see a thick coat of fur and thick skin on this polar bear. Can you think of the reason why do polar animals have thick skin and thick fur? The reason is these animals have thick fur to survive in extremely cold weather. Just as you wear sweaters and jackets to avoid cold, these animals have been given thick fur by nature to survive in extremely cold areas. How are polar animals able to walk on ice without slipping? When you attempt to walk on ice, you may slip. Even on a wet surface, we can slip. How do polar animals survive without slipping? Their feet have special structures, and those structures help them to walk on ice. Can you name five plants and animals that share your habitat? Think of some plants and some animals that are present in the area where you live. You need to put their names in order. You may find some of the following plants and animals present in your area. Rose plant, orange tree, mango tree, wheat crop, and sugarcane. And for animals, you may find cat, dog, cow, horse, and donkey. These are some of the most common plants and animals that are present in the area where us human beings live. Which of the following animals can you find in a jungle? Do you find a polar bear in a jungle? Or do you have a chance of seeing a deer in a jungle? The correct answer is, you may find a deer in a jungle because polar bear is only found in very cold regions where there are no trees and obviously no forests. Another question coming your way is, which of the following habitats are most suitable for penguins? We have just seen penguins. Can you tell which area would they prefer to live in? The polar regions or the grasslands or the extremely hot deserts? The correct answer is that penguins like to live in the polar regions. We shall now summarize what we have studied so far in this lesson. Habitat is the environment where a plant or animal lives. Living things cannot survive outside their natural habitat. Polar regions, forests, deserts, mountains, rivers, and seas, these all are different types of habitat. Animals of polar region have special body features that help them survive in those extremely cold areas. So, now on to your home task. You have to read pages 2 and 3 of the textbook, and you have to attempt exercise question C2 as shown in this picture on page 4 of the textbook on your notebooks. Good luck!